Continuing our series on elements found in questions on statics, we are going to cover pulleys today. Pulleys are very helpful devices. They're one of the primary machines. And what they do is they help us in redirecting the line of action of strings. So the question we have over here, the situation we have over here, there's a rigid wall, a ceiling to which a rigid member is attached. From there, a pin joint, this black hole over here, using that pin joint, a pulley has been attached. A string passes over it. At one end of the string, a mass M has been tied, and the other end of the string is being held by this person. Now, what we want to understand is that how much force does that person have to apply in order to keep this mass afloat? So we start like we always do. We first make an isolation volume around this mass. And since we've already done this a few times, we can see very safely that T2 is equal to mg. Now that we know T2, we want to know T1, because T1 is the force that the person has to apply in order to keep this mass stationary. So to do that, what we do is we make an isolation volume around this pulley. So we cut this string over here, go around the pulley, cut the string over here, come around here, and cut this member over here. So there are three cuts that we have made, 1, 2, and 3. So we'll just bring the pulley over here and draw it. This is our pulley. Now, as we already know, these tensions, they will be moving outwards from the isolation volume, which is this volume. So you have T1 downwards, T2 downwards, and also T1 downwards. Now, here is where a pin joint is important. A pin joint, which is over here, can provide no torque, but it can provide two reactions, one in the vertical direction and one in the horizontal direction. So let us make this one R1. This is the reaction, and R2. Now this pulley is a body. That is, the exact position of these forces is important, and you'll see why in a moment. Now, first of all, balancing vertical forces, we can say that R1 minus T1 minus T2 is equal to 0. So R1 is equal to T1 plus T2. Next, we can say that R2 is equal to 0, since it's the only horizontal force. Finally, we'll have to balance moments. Now, a very convenient point to balance moments about is this point, since then R1 and R2 are no longer in the picture. If the radius of the pulley is small r, in that case, the moment caused by this force is T2 into R, and this is in the negative direction, since this will be clockwise, plus T1 into R positive, since this is counterclockwise, is equal to 0. What this does is, this gives us T1 is equal to T2. And this result, that the tension across two ends of the string going over a pulley are equal, is universal. It doesn't matter whether these strings are parallel or they're at an angle, because that doesn't create any difference as far as this moment balance equation is concerned. So as long as this pulley is light and it's frictionless, this relation is held true. So we'll just assume it directly without having to go through this step. So from here, we can see that T1 is equal to T2 is equal to mg. Hence, this person has to apply a force equal to mg in order to keep this mass from falling down. Now, you would say, in any case, even if the pulley was not there, this person would have to apply the same amount of force to keep the mass from falling. So what advantage do pulleys provide? For that, let's go to the next problem. The problem over here is that you again have this mass. So you have a T1 over here, you have a T2 over here, and you have a T3 over here, and you have this mass. So, what we can already see from the previous result is that since T1 and T2 are the two tensions across this pulley, and this is a frictionless pulley, T1 is equal to T2. Similarly, since T2 is one end and T3 is one end, the tensions of this pulley, so T2 is equal to T3. So T1 is equal to T2 is equal to T3. So then all we need to do is first we see this isolation volume, and there is a cut which is being produced over here. So this cut, so balancing the forces, you have this mass M. You have an upwards force, let's denote that by R, and you have a downwards force of mg. So we can simply say that R is equal to mg. Now let's make this cut. Cut over here, over here, over here. This is the isolation volume. So in that case, what we have is we have this pulley. We have T2. We have T3. And we have this reaction downwards, R. Again, since we are cutting it over here, this reaction has to go downwards. So this is equal to R. So immediately what we can see is R is equal to T2 plus T3. But since T1 equal to T2 is equal to 2T3, we can simply write this as R is equal to 2T1. And since R is equal to mg, what we can see is P1 is equal to mg by 2. Now here is where pulleys are really helpful. We can see that with this clever arrangement, in spite of the fact that the weight of this object is mg, the force that this person is having to apply is only mg by 2. And we can in fact cascade these arrangements further to make this value even smaller. Now, how does this exactly happen? This happen to see that what we do is we erase these volumes and we directly make an isolation volume around over here. So now that the internal forces are not important, what we can see is the downward force of mg is balanced by two strings instead of one string in the previous example, where this downward force of mg was balanced by one string. Over here, the downward force of mg is balanced by two strings, both of which have been tensed at the rate of T1 newtons. Hence, both of them, since there are two strings, they only have to be half as tensed as the mass to be able to pick the mass up. It's basic divide and rule strategy. Please take time to pause the screen and solve this question.